If you can imagine a sine wave, and let's say a bass guitar is a sine wave generator. Like if I took this guitar and I took some epoxy and I epoxied a ballpoint pen refill down there, pressing down on this, and I pick the string like that and I pull the paper, what there would be a squiggle, we call a sine wave, on the paper.
What else do you have new for this year, if you want to just kind of run down the list, so if it strikes their interest, folks could look it up?
Well, we have a lot of new things. I don't know whether I can. One of the things that I think your folks might be interested in is these little boys.
Okay.
Pick it up.
Yeah, it's very light. That's a bass amp.
Yeah.
Yep.
And here's its big brother.
Wow.
We have sent a bunch of these out for evaluation, and the reports that we've been getting back are awesome.
What was the change? What made bass amps so light now?
Well, it's called switch mode power supplies and class D amplifiers. I can tell you, if you want to know.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. If you can imagine a sine wave. And let's say a bass guitar is a sine wave generator. Like if I took this guitar and I took some epoxy and I epoxied a ballpoint pen refill down there, pressing down on this, and I picked the string like that and I pulled the paper, what there would be a squiggle, we call a sine wave, on the paper. Well, transistors act like variable resistors. Trans means between. Istor is the suffix of resistor. So it is literally a variable resistor. Now, a transistor in a power amp has minimum heat dissipation only at two points, when no current is passing at all, and when it's turned absolutely totally on, where you just have the internal resistance of the device, okay? So off and full on are the two times that a transistor dissipates the least heat and waste energy as heat. You with me? Off, full on,
right?
Okay? Well, a sine wave, if you can imagine, it has a center point. It goes up, and it comes back down to zero, and it goes down. Well, when it's at zero, no current is flowing. When it's up at the top, maximum current is flowing, and at both of those points in time, the transistor has minimum heat loss, minimum dissipation, maximum efficiency. But at any point between off and up here, it's dissipating heat. It goes up, it turns on more and more and more, goes up, is fully on, and then it starts coming back down. And all those things, except when it crosses the center line and at the max, it's dissipating heat.
Right.
A switch mode amplifier works a different way, but utilizing the principles of the transistor. It literally is a switch. It's off and on, off and on. And the transit time from off to full on is very small. In the time domain, it's tiny. So with a typical class AB amplifier, like if this is a 1,000-watt amplifier, okay? In a class AB amplifier, a typical, the technology we've been using for 70 years, you have to have a power supply to supply twice the energy to the amplifier, because it's only 50% efficient.
Right.
So if you got a 1,000-watt amplifier, guess what? You got to have 2,000-watt power supply. It's heavy, it's big, and copper is costly.
Right.
Transformers are costly. So a switch mode amplifier does away with most of that. A switching power supply, it's the actual transistors or MOSFETs in many cases, it's either on or off.
Right.
Zero current, maximum current.
And that allows you to.
So you get minimum heat.
Sure.
So several things are operating. Because this is probably around 86 or 87% efficient, you get a lot less heat. You do get some.
Right.
But you don't have to have a 2,000-watt power supply.
Right.
So to get 1,000 watts with a conventional, you got to have a 2,000-watt power supply, so you got 1,500 watts.
Right. It's a lot of weight, too.
I mean, but this thing here, it weighs, I guess, about 10 pounds.
Yeah. I remember the old bass amps were twice the size of a guitar amp.
Well, we used to do that. We've been building switching amps for a long time. Mm-hmm. When we first started doing it, the devices themselves were not available.
But isn't bigger better?
No, a lot of people think that.
Right.
A lot of people think that, but we're doing it more efficiently.
Right.
I mean, if you had a prop plane and you wanted to break the speed of sound, can you imagine how many propellers you would have to have?
Sure.
Well, there's a better way to do
it. That's right.
And our friends from way out there, mm-hmm. they don't use jets or anything else.
Right.
They've discovered anti-gravity.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I think we have too, but the government just won't tell us about it.
Nice.
But that's another story. No, technology is amazing. We're doing things now with technology that 10 years ago would have appeared to be magic.
Right.
And some of the things that we're doing, I mean, this amp, the Viper Pro,
yeah.
I will gladly compare that with some of these fancy digital modeling amps that cost $2,000,
right.
Or preamps in some cases. I mean, we've compared them, and we're as good or better at a hell of a lot less money. People say, well, why do you do that? Same answer as before, because we can.
Right.
You see, I've told you this before, I think. If you're smart, you learn something every day.
Right.
And that's true, something good, something bad. Yes, you do make mistakes, especially when you're pushing the state of the art,
mm-hmm.
but you learn. Every mistake is a learning opportunity if you use it for that. So we keep inventing and pushing and growing, and one of my favorite things is for somebody to tell me can't be done.
Right.
BS. It probably can be done, and if we don't do it, somebody else will. So that's why I keep pushing and pushing and pushing, and we do, you know, a lot of crazy things. Like we've got a new steel guitar amplifier over there. You know, almost everybody that's tried to get in the steel guitar business have jumped in it and jump back at it, because not that many steel players.
Sure.
Besides that, if you think about a pedal steel guitar,
uh-huh.
it's got 10 strings, sometimes double necks with all those, and it's one of the hardest things there is to amplify, because those guys, the steel players, can use those pedals and lay down uh-huh. those strings like a wet noodle,
right.
and that just drives speakers crazy.
Uh-huh.
I've got a steel guitar amp over there with 1,000 watts, a special Blackwood speaker that we make.
Right.
And because we've tried the friendly competitors' speakers, and they just don't work. As a matter of fact, I think I've told you this before, in almost any sound system, from a car radio to the largest sound system you can imagine, what goes first when you turn the volume wide open? Answer, speakers.
Right.
That's why we make speakers,
mm-hmm.
because the speaker is the weakest link. And also, a lot of people don't know that loudspeakers, conventional loudspeakers, are terribly inefficient. They, even the best efficient speakers, are about 4 or 5% efficient, which means you stick in 100 watts, you get 4 or 5 watts of equivalent sound, and the rest of it is heat. And at 100 watts, that's not a problem. At 1,000 watts, you got yourself a hairdryer. And that's the kind of thing that is difficult. So anyway, it's the quest to be the best is never ending at PV.
Well, I appreciate. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
On behalf of everyone, all of your fans, and thank you very much. I mean, we love your products. We love what you do. That Piranha looks awesome, by the way. So thank you for yet again another awesome.
Go check it out.
Yeah. Yep. And even those microheads, that was like a home run.
Well, if you look at that microhead,
those are awesome.
None of our friendly competitors, they most of them have little 20-watt amplifiers.
Yep.
But you look at the back panel,
yep.
our back panel alone.
That has more feature than any other amp of that, you know, class has. I mean,
that's the way PV yeah. does it. In fact, as we sit around a conference room in our engineering department and yell and scream at each other.
Right.
Now, most companies, you don't do that, mm-hmm. especially
sure.
for the owner.
Right.
But you know this better than anybody.
Right.
Music is about passion.
That's right.
If what you do, regardless, if there's no passion in it, you're probably not going to be very good.
Right.
Well, music is about passion, and we are passionate about what we do, because were that not the case, you wouldn't see all this stuff.
That's right.
That's right.
Okay?
Awesome. Mr. Peavy, it's so nice seeing you again. Thank you.
Hartley. I'm not that old.
Hartley. Have a great winter, Nam.
Okay.
And we'll leave you all off with one of those right there.
All right.
Thank you.